Hello guys, welcome again to this channel, and we will continue giving you more videos. So kindly, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please kindly do so. Just subscribe, like the video. That one is the only support you can give us, guys. Just subscribe and like the video. In Nyongesa Sande, we have a lot of things for you to read, so much more to read now, and so much more to watch and listen. So it's our opinions. You can buy them or you can disagree with them. So if you agree with us, you can let us know in the comments below. And also, if you don't buy whatever we are saying, if you don't agree with our views, you can also comment so that you can know where to correct. And there is some Wazee na Rungu in Eldoret. This old generation, the people who came before us, you know, they are so much entrenched into tribalism, and the generation of up to 1990, this generation is like part of the older generation. So what they do, they are so much entrenched into tribal politics. Tribal politics and religiosity. So the current generation of 2000s and these other millennials, what they think is they are technologically advanced and they know truth. So for them, you cannot lie to them. In fact, the president wanted the leaders, the current MPs, they thought that this thing will be tribal. You see, they are trying to push tribal narrative, but it is not coming up. It's only in Eldoret where I saw the old Wazees with the rungus, very tall rungus, and you're doing some kind of oath, trying to, like, saying they want to protect their president from their son or something like that. So I don't know what they were speaking, because they were speaking in their Kalenjin dialect. And so this kind of things of tribalism has brought us down. We have not been moving forward as a country, because if you go to tribalism, if a leader is useless, you'll still elect him because he is your tribe. You see, especially the president, for instance, or the governor. So you will see, this guy cannot perform. This guy is not yet there. He's not yet ready to be a president or a governor. So, but because he is my tribe, I would rather choose him than choose the other guy. So this kind of things of tribalism is very, very bad. It is has really made us, you see everywhere we have jobless youth. You know, there is nothing Ruto will do, because these kids, millions, they are in millions and they have no job. So the only thing they see is, you want to shoot, it's better you to shoot me so that I can go. You see, that's what they are trying to tell the president. The president is very is fooled by the kind of guys around him, like Kichungwa, Muhammad Ali, Didmas Barasa, this kind of guys. They cannot advise. These guys cannot think. If the president wants to work, he should surround himself with people who can advise him, not Kimani Ichung'wa. Kimani Ichung'wa, there is no advice. He can even not give a frog an advice. Even a frog cannot listen to Kimani Ichung'wa. But the president is the advice of this president is Kimani Ichung'wa, Dennis Itumbi, Didmas Barasa, Dindi Nyoro, Silvana Sosoro. I don't know what the president is trying to do. I don't understand him, because the people who surround him, if you see them, you know that this guy cannot work. Some people who supported the president are telling us that we should wait for some time. He can do, he can work. A person who can work, we see from the people he has surrounded himself with. We will see the kind of ministers he has chosen. We will see the kind of people that are advising him. If the advice of the president comes from Ichung'wa, then what are you telling us that we should wait, we should give them time? Ichung'wa is there to amass wealth. These guys, Didimas, he bought a jet, a helicopter. They are making money out of our taxes. They don't want to work for the future of this country. You elected people who went there to eat. So it is this time. What I can advise the president is, if he survives, this Gen Z's, of which I'm not sure if he'll survive, because they are idle, they are jobless, they have nothing to do other than to protest. Now they have a job. The Gen Z's now have a job of going every week to protest. That is what they, that is their job now, you see. So it is very hard for you to win this war, Mr. Ruto. If you survive, please dissociate yourself with the likes of Ichungwa. Reconstitute your cabinet, remove those guys and get competent people. We have people who can think. And also, for you to survive as a president, Mr. Ruto, what you should do will be to listen also to some people. It should not be always about you, or you should not show us that you are Mr. Know-it-all, that you cannot listen to anybody. You see, try to listen to what people are saying. And so you have been given a chance to lead the people, to make Africa great again. But now you went there and you are very arrogant. Your people, all your MPs, you've bought them. All the MPs are arrogant. They don't give a damn. And in fact, what I can say is that the people should visit all MPs who voted yes and deal with them in an orderly manner. Make sure that they learn that you elected them, and the madarao that they showed you guys by voting and voting, whether people are being shot, they are still voting yes. You see, this kind is madarao ile ya hali ya juu. So please guys, make sure if we get the chance for elections, put tribe aside, put religion aside, think critically of who can work for this nation. Like for instance, Nairobi, they gave you a good guy who could have worked for the Nairobi County. Now Nairobi looks like it is the dirtiest city in the world, you see, and they are collecting a lot of money. So you decided to choose this guy, Mr. Dimbles, Sakaja, Johnson Sakaja, over a person who is known, who could have managed Nairobi very well. Nairobi does not need a politician. Nairobi needs a manager, and it can work. But now we went, we said, this guy is from Uhuru, so we cannot choose him. We did not choose a governor of Nairobi thinking of the future of the city. We chose with emotions, like, this guy is from Jubilee, Uhuru's guy. They say, what is this? Then we chose Sakaja over Polycarp Igathe. So you can see the city is not a city anymore. That city is in chaos. That city is the dirtiest city to ever exist. I think it's the dirtiest city in Africa. Because we have a useless governor in power. And he won the election because of what? Because people believed, this guy is from the dynasty. He has been fronted by Uhuru. Uhuru wants to continue ruling through this guy in the city. That is the thing that people are saying before they went and voted Sakaja. Some voted Sakaja because of tribe. And some voted for him because he was associated with the president. And the president was a prayerful man. He was, at that time, he was ABCD. So you can see that we are the problem of this country. The older generations are the problem of this country. The only way we can save this country is if we shun tribalism, we shun religiosity, if we shun this nepotism and all this kind of useless politics, useless thinking. Like, if you go to vote, why will you vote for Sakaja? Because you believe that Polycarp Igathe is being fronted by Uhuru, and you had Uhuru. You see, that is a problem, guys. We have a big problem. So guys, in case you are new on this channel, please kindly subscribe and like this video, and make sure you wait for the next video. We are here to drop videos and drop videos and drop videos. Thank you so much, guys.